Mr. Molly has been dead for 7 years.
7 years? Then why is he staying so long time?
Not out of sentiment, I can assure you. Uncle Ebenezer is a little close to his money, and a new sign would cost something.
He's the one he wants to sing the special song for?
That's right, Polly. Let's go in and give everybody some Christmas cheer.
From the way it looks, they sure could use a little.
Christmas, Uncle. God bless you.
Bah, humbug.
Christmas, a humbug? Uncle Ebenezer, you don't mean that, I'm sure.
I most certainly do. Merry Christmas, indeed. What right have you to be married? You're poor enough.
Quite true, but then what reason do you have to be married? You're rich enough.
Bah, humbug.
Come now, Uncle, don't be cross. It's Christmas.
Bah.
And I have a special song for you.
Humbug.
Around with this
Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas. For a minute, I'm putting a very bitter stake of holly through his heart.
Uncle.
Not you. Keep Christmas in your own way and let me keep it in mine.
Keep it, but you don't keep it at all.
Then let me leave it alone. I can't see it's ever done you any good.
You always confuse good with profit. Many things have been good to me, but without profit. And that's certainly true of Christmas. It's a good time. A kind, forgiving, charitable, and pleasant time. It's a time when we all open up our hearts and reach out to others to make the world a better place. I don't care what you say, Uncle. Christmas has been good to me, and it will always be good to me. And I say God bless it.
Let me hear another word from you, and you'll celebrate Christmas by losing your employment. Quite a powerful speaker, sir. I wonder you don't go into Parliament. Now you listen to me. I say Christmas is humbug. Bah, humbug. Bah, humbug. It's hustle, bustle, push and muscle, rushing to and fro. It's people crowding, people out, who got some place to go. It's acrid smells and raucous bells, and singing out of key. It's those Christmas trees that make you sneeze and lose your dignity. Bah humbug. Bah humbug. These platitudes for multitudes you endlessly repeat are winter tales to push the sale of trinkets on the street. That Christmas cheer you hold so dear is phony as can be. The milk of human kindness in a bitter cup of tea. Oh, Christmas is a waste of time, a tasteless time, not worth the dime. It is a most disgraceful time to keep it in the crime.
Oh, Christmas is a waste of time, a tasteless time, not worth the dime. It is a most disgraceful time to keep it is a crime.
Very confidentially, if you could scrimp and scratch it till you're rich as you can be, would you give up one tiny token from your treasure chest to waste it for the chance to wear this tasteless Christmas vest?
Oh, Christmas is a waste of time, a tasteless time, not worth the dime. It is a most disgraceful time to keep it is a crime.
A chimney where the smoke goes up is filled with grime and soot. Yet there's no Mutz, a Nicholas, from starchy beer to boot. Yet isn't he the jolly one who makes your dreams come true? He wouldn't know a reindeer if he saw one in the zoo. Oh, Christmas is a folkish lore, please underscore, a folkish lore. Christmas is a dreadful bore, to keep it is a chore. From outer space. Now isn't that insane? Yet that's what this foolish fable feebly would explain. Are you so full of wonder that you're willing to rely on miracles, empirical deductions will deny?
Oh, Christmas is a waste of time, a tasteless time, not worth a dime. It is a most disgraceful time to keep it is a crime. Oh, Christmas is a waste of time, a tasteless time, not worth the dime. It is a most disgraceful time to keep it is a crime.
Have you
decided to get married?
Because I fell in love.
Humbug. There's anything more stupid than Christmas. It's falling in love. Good afternoon.
I want nothing of you. I ask nothing of you. Why can't we be friends?
Good afternoon.
I'm sorry, with all my heart, to see you so firmly resolved in this isolation, hopeless. Well, I came here in the spirit of Christmas, and I shall leave in it. So, Merry Christmas, Uncle.
Good afternoon.
And Happy New Year!
Good afternoon!
Merry Christmas to all of you, and thank you for coming by to cheer us up. I hope you'll come visit me tomorrow. We can't offer much to eat or drink, but there will be plenty of singing and dancing. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Bye. Bless you, sir. And are you Mr. Scrooge or Mr. Marley?
Bless you, good lady. But I'm Bob Cratchit. Mr. Marley died 7 years ago this very night. This is Mr. Scrooge.
Ah, Mr. Scrooge. No doubt Mr. Marley's generosity is well represented by his surviving partner. May we present our credentials? At this festive time of the year, Mr. Scrooge, it is more than ever desirable that we make a contribution to the poor and destitute, those in want of common comfort, those in desperate circumstances, and in need of the absolute necessities of life.
I see. I take it that prisons have been closed and in workhouses.
Oh, no, Mr. Scrooge. They are more plentiful than ever, I'm afraid.
Splendid. For a moment there, there's a problem with no solution. Please be good enough to round up your corps and let the state take care of it.
I do believe he's jesting. I don't think so. Mr. Scrooge, a few of us are endeavoring to raise the funds to buy the poor some meat, drink, and warm clothing. We choose this time because it is a time when want is keenly felt and abundance rejoices. What may we put you down for, Mr. Scrooge?
Nothing, my dear lady, nothing.
You wish to remain anonymous?
I wish to be left alone. I don't make myself merry at Christmas, and I can't afford to make idle people merry. I mind my business, and I pay my taxes. You're the taxpayer to pay for your poor, that's what it's for.
But, sir, there isn't enough tax money to go around.
It's not my business. It's enough for a man to understand his own business and not to interfere with others. Good afternoon. Pay maybe half a crown for it. You would consider yourself ill-used. Yet you don't consider me ill-used when I pay a day's wages for no work at all.
But, sir, Christmas comes once a year.
A poor excuse for picking a man's pocket, just because the date happened to be December 25th. Very well, then. Suppose you must all have the whole day off. Be here all early the next morning.
Thank you. once.
Much. Who are you? Ask me who I was.
Very well. Who were you then? This is the ghost that saves your shape particularly.
There's no time for jokes. In life I was your partner, Jacob Marley.
Please, Mr. Marley. But Jacob, can you sit down?
I can.
Then please do so.
You don't believe in me.
Well,
do you?
No, I don't.
You see and hear me, do you not?
I don't know.
Why do you doubt your senses?
So many little things can affect them. This late disorder of your stomach can make a cheat of your senses. You may be just an undigested bit of beef. A lot of mustard. A crumb of cheese, perhaps an underdone potato. But whatever you are, there's more gravy than grave about you.
I see, yes. Very well. Go on.
See this toothpick?
I do.
I have but just one of this. And for the rest of my days, I shall be haunted by a legion of goblins. All of my own creation. Humbug, you see it all? Humbug. Mercy, mercy. Dreadful apparition, why do you trouble me so?
Condemned to walk the earth and witness what I cannot share. I am forced to serve out my time, seeing what I would not see when I was living, because I never gave happiness. I now wander endlessly alone, in agony and pain, suffering and shame, a prisoner of the twisted cloak of chains.
Ghastly, but why are you in chains?
I wear the chain I forged in life. I made it link by link, yard by yard, day by day, deed by deed. I wrapped this chain around myself, and I did so of my own free will. Tell me, Ebenezer, is the pattern familiar to you?
Me? Well, why to me?
Of course, you wouldn't know. Alive, you cannot see the links, nor feel the weight of the massive change you wear yourself. It was as full and as heavy as mine 7 Christmas Eves ago. You have labored on it since. Oh, Ebenezer, it is now a ponderous chain.
Please, good old Jacob Merton, don't worry. Speak, comfort to me, Jacob.
I have none to give. That has left 2 others and 4 others. Only a little more time with me is permitted to you. I cannot stay. I cannot rest. I cannot linger anywhere. In life, my spirit never walks beyond our counting house, never beyond the narrow limits of our money-changing totem. And now will be a weary journey of life before me.
But you were always a good man of business, Jacob.
Business? Business, you say? Ebenezer, mankind is the real business. Living is the real business. Our little race is nothing but a drop of unclean water in the whole ocean. That is the real business of life. At this time of year, I suffer the most. How could I walk through the crowded streets, eyes turned down, never once looking up to see the blessed star the white wind follows? Were there no four homes to which this light might have led me?
Oh, poor Jacob, originally you suffered.
Yes, but hear me, Ebenezer, my time is nearly gone.
I will, but you must help me. What is it you have come to say?
Ebenezer, you can see me now, I may not tell. I have stood visible beside you many times before, there is no light part of my penance. I am here tonight to warn you, you have yet a shadow of hope in escaping my fate. I've asked for this and it's been granted.
You were always a good friend to me, Jacob. And I thank you.
You will be haunted by 50 spirits tonight. A different one at each hour. The first will come at 1 o'clock.
Is that the chance of hope you mentioned, Jacob?
It is.
I think I'd rather not.
Without their visits, there is no hope for you.
What will they do? How should I behave? You must tell me. I'm afraid.
When the clock strikes one, when the clock strikes one, and the dark of the night will begin, let the spirits come, let the spirits come, till the work of the night is done. Oh.
will know much more than you have before when the work of the night is done.
Things as they are. I want both of you to come over to my house for a celebration. work has been good thanks to your hard work. Thank you, boys, and Merry Christmas to you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Mr. Fezaway. And Merry Christmas to you. You made ours a merry one indeed.
You're much too kind, sir, but we thank you just the same. You are a good, good man. Merry Christmas.
The child knows his heart beats, the child. It's 2 o'clock, and I'm here.
But.
Well, weren't you expecting me?
Yes, but.
But what?
You're not what I expected.
I expect so. You see, I'm not to be expected. But with a present, I'm always present.
What is this? Who are you?
The spirit of Christmas present. Of course.
Of course. Why, of course?
Christmas present? Christmas present.
Christmas presents? Christmas presents?
That's the spirit!
That doesn't make sense.
Oh, dear. I was told you were going to be difficult.
Hey, what is all this about? I don't understand.
Very well. I shall have to explain to you. I got red hot chestnuts by the basket, cherry cheeks, apples nice and bright, hams and turkey, sausages and chickens, doesn't that quicken your appetite? Figs and raisins, quince, mince pies, plums, cocoa, lemons and limes. All are edible, just to be credible, try a little pinch and see if it fries. Huckleberry, Loganberry, cranberry, blueberry, raspberry, gooseberry, how about a merry little cherry this time? It's apple the run. Two kids giving out Christmas candy.
Keeps hair strong and healthy.
Tresemme, Tresemme.
Professional, affordable Tresemme.
Chips Ahoy Warm and Chewy, the first Chips Ahoy made special for the microwave.
Dry skin is a nasty little problem, but extra dry skin, the kind that's tight, itchy, and uncomfortable, now that's a big problem. Fortunately, there's advanced therapy from Lubriderm. It's a really rich and creamy Lubriderm with special nutrients and vitamins. And that puts the problem of extra dry skin out of sight and out of mind. Advanced therapy from Lubriderm. Later, Gator.
A message from the law offices of James Sokolov on mesothelioma. Mesothelioma is a rare, malignant type of cancer in the lungs, usually associated with exposure to asbestos. If you or a loved one have been diagnosed with mesothelioma, call the law offices of James Sokolov at 1-800-342-3348. That's 1-800-342-3348. 3348 1-800-342-3348.
But a letter don't let out. But a letter don't do. But a letter don't do. Don't let out.
Serenity Dry Active Liners from Tena, designed to fit your style.
You are a superhero to someone. So act like one and take a premium vitamin. Mega Men Multivitamins, exclusively from General Nutrition Centers, with 39 premium ingredients for men, including things like lutein and lycopene. So it's more than just a multivitamin. Take care of yourself, superhero. Someone's watching you. And for super moms, there's Women's Ultra Mega, only from GNC.
No job is too hard, no mission too big, and no spy too small. Spy Kids 2, the Island of Lost Dreams Collector Series, rated PG. Now on DVD and video.
French Toast Swirl Bread from Pepperidge Farm. Deep, delicious curves of brown sugar and cinnamon. Swirled in sweet-smelling slices. So thick and rich, it doesn't go with breakfast. It is breakfast. Pepperidge Farm. Never have an ordinary day.
Michael
Jackson Network, all Jackson all the time. This week alone, he's commanding 7 hours of network television. Last night, ABC repeated Martin Bashir's documentary. NBC ran its own special, Michael Jackson Unmasked, where it showed his transformation from black to white and from nose to noseless. Well, it's true. It's true. And but you know what?
It he's also, still black. He may not know it, but he's still black.
Okay. All right. Whatever he is.
He's still black.
But also,
you don't get to change.
But wait, listen. Doesn't the body match the face? Because he's done something.
Listen, the last time I checked, I have not looked at that boy's body that close, but...
No,
you're too
old.
You know why you haven't seen it? You're too old.
One of the detectives who did investigate him back in 93 when those allegations came up of child abuse was on last night on the NBC 2 hour special, and he truly believes that Michael Jackson is a pedophile.
But what about the parents? Why not investigate the parents who take their kids and drop them off over there?
Somebody else said that position when they sat with
us. I don't know.
Leave my kids alone.
Stupid
with...
again.
S-T-U-P-I-D. I won't leave my kids alone with my husband. Much less because I want them to be fed,
What do you think about, there's been some criticism of Bashir because Michael Jackson's rebuttal is on, I think it's on Fox this week.
On Thursday.
Where he shows videotape that his people took while Bashir is interviewing him. And at one point, Bashir says words to the effect that you're a great father, your relationship with your children is incredible, all of that.
People lie.
Well, but
not to suggest that he wasn't. It was just he was lulling him into a false.
But is that right to do?
But you even saw that without that. That Bashir was really. It was like listening to a tabloid to listen to him. There was something creepy and sleazy about him.
Well, is that creepy though? Yeah, you make a good point.
But you had to know it. That's the point. You had to know.
Michael Jackson, setting him up.
He's got a strong ego, Michael Jackson.
Yes,
how else is he supposed to spend time 8 months with the guy without, kissing his tush a little bit?
But that's just it's lying. He's setting him up because he plans to reveal the guy.
But no, it's not lying. It's
sure
selective.
It is.
It's
They're both going in wanting something out of this. And I think because Bashir did Princess Di, Michael Jackson sees himself as a similar icon and thinks he's going to get that kind of treatment.
It is an entrapment.
Anybody's going to court.
No.
I mean, that's the point. But you need to know, Michael is sophisticated. You can say whatever you want. The guy is a musical genius. He's been making money and records for a long time. He's smart. So why would you ever presume that this person is there to do something
area, he may not be so smart.
Right.
There's something called
emotional intelligence, and he's a double-digit IQ on that one.
Yeah.
You might be right.
You know what I want to talk about?
I could never imagine that. But can I talk about
something positive?
An icon that I have to tell you. The only thing I've been really looking forward to since we got here, I had lunch yesterday with the great Sidney Poitier. The most amazing man I've ever met.
He's there every day.
It was the most amazing experience. And he gave me just some advice, and I'm going to share it with all of you. He said many years ago, he decided to learn at least one new word a day and add it to his vocabulary so that there would be texture and depth to every conversation, that he could add something new to it. So I thought that was a very good life lesson.
We should do
that. So that we should do that also.
We need that.
To add new words to our vocabulary.
New words? We learned stupid today. We learned that.
Speaking of words, Patricia, the award ceremony recently. What was it, the American Music Awards?
Yeah, it's American Music Awards.
You walked out because of the words the Osbournes were using, which a lot of profanity.
Made quite a scene.
We talked about it.
It was on at 8 o'clock. My biggest objection was on at 8 o'clock at night when people think they can sit down with their kids. And people were turning it off right and left. I got thousands and thousands of emails and letters, and one from George Bush Sr. also
really
upset about it. Yeah,
he was watching.
We were in the middle of hell, and he was watching. George Bush Sr. presented a tribute to the group Alabama, and he was upset.
I'm calm now.
He's like, it's not in the Gulf War anymore. Let's watch this TV.
The son was watching Joe Millionaire. There you go. All right, we gotta go. We got so much show and so little time. Guess who's coming out? We'll be right back with She's Great, Julianne Moore.
Whoa!
Right back. Whoa!
go ahead. The ladies are interrogating the Shield star, Michael Chiklis. And one of our fans isn't punching the clock for a while because we're sweeping her off her feet, giving her a taste of what it's like to be a Hollywood hotshot with the full celebrity treatment. And part one begins today.
New Easy Off Microwave Wipes. Let the heat-activated formula create a mist to loosen even stuck-on food, then wipe it clean. New Easy Off Microwave Wipes from the oven cleaning experts.
Wait! Don't let winter dry out your lips. Give them ChapStick Lip Moisturizer. 10 moisturizers like aloe and vitamin E in a protective moisturizing formula. ChapStick.
Wait!
It's what dry chapped lips are thirsting for.
What's it like to punch into a toy? Creamy, curly, chewy, crunchy, crunchy, DJRAP.
Crunch into a Twix?
Oh,
what's your one thing?
Everyone loves all-natural Capri Sun. It's made of stuff I've actually heard of, and it disappears as fast as they do. Capri Sun. It's liquid cool.
They reminded me of you.
The color of being adored, Hydrance Hair Color and Golden Sunrise. The color of being ravishing, Hydrance Red Hibiscus. Hydrance, the color of being good to yourself. Hydrance exclusive deep moisturizing color cream doesn't dry out your hair. It saturates every strand with colors so lush and radiant, it turns even your gray gorgeous. The color of being good to yourself. Hydrance from Clairol.
Color wonderful.
Introducing a new overnight laxative, Freelax. These have stimulants that can jolt your system and cause cramps.
Freelax is different.
It's stimulant-free and cramp-free. It's new, different, it's Freelax.
It works overnight and no cramps. Freelax.
You're 2 years old, developing a strong sense of self. This week, yourself is a superhero, wearing Pampers Easy Ups. They fit like real underwear, super underwear. Easy Ups, created by Pampers.
That's me. And this is Kate. She's just like me. First bike ride, first prom. Then my little girl grew up. Around then, I was diagnosed with rheumatoid arthritis. Still, things were looking up. Until I turned 50. I felt 90.
For some, there's Remicade. Remicade relieves pain and helps stop further damage to your joints. Your doctor may add Remicade if you're on methotrexate already and not responding well. Remicade is not for everyone. Certain people with heart failure should not take Remicade. Serious, sometimes fatal infections such as TB have been reported. Your doctor should evaluate your risk of infection. Tell your doctor right away if you develop any sign of an infection while on Remicade. There is a risk of serious infusion reactions, which may include hives, difficulty breathing, and low blood pressure. Call today and talk to your rheumatologist.
Last year, Kate was diagnosed with rheumatoid arthritis. And she's so young. At least she won't suffer like I did.
Wednesday sizzles. First at a special time, 8, 7 Central, who will Trista choose? It's the 2-hour television event that'll leave you speechless.
I'm sorry.
The Bachelorette season finale. Then, 10 celebrities compete for food, water, and clothing on the premiere of...
I'm a celebrity!
Get me out of here!
Sizzling Wednesday, starting at 8, 7 Central on ABC.
One Life to Live gives you what you, the fans, have asked for.
I wish Clint was back.
Hello, Tad.
How do you know Tad?
How do you know Tad?
It's Fan February. One Life to Live tomorrow.
For those of you watching at home, I could say that Julianne Moore had a sex change during the commercial break, but that would not be true. This is more true. STUPID, Julianne Moore is not here. John Ritter is here. Yes. You know, he's on 8 Simple Rules for Dating My Teenage Daughter. The one and only John Ritter plays the one and only. Like, I knew him before, but now he's the one and only. He plays a frantic father who's learning that when it comes to raising a teen, the only calm is right before the storm. Take a look.
I thought we made an agreement. We were going to stay calm.
Stay calm, even though she's stolen our car and driven across the state line.
Yes.
And as we speak, she's in some boy's college dorm room.
Yes.
And that boy happens to be a musician. You used to date a musician, didn't you, Kate? Kate, slow down. What happened to calm?
Screw calm.
Crosswalk, crosswalk.
That's exactly how I feel right now. Welcome, John Ritter. John, can you forgive me?
I loved it.
Did you?
I looked at Michael Chiklis with the new eyes. Hello.
Excuse me, and what'd you do with that wig? Because I might need to wear it later on. Okay.
She's right back
okay,
there.
Okay, don't be talking right. The hair. You get to beat
hey.
That.
Hey.
You got that,
are you a fan
baby.
Of those reality shows, by the way? Mm-hmm. Do you watch any of them, John?
Well, you know, I wanted to talk to Barbara Walters because... She's interviewing, Robert Blake.
Yes, she did yesterday.
Yeah.
For, you know, and his big theme was, I'm a celebrity, get me out of here. That would be the show. Who's hot and who's not?
In your show, you have two teenage daughters. You're going through the whole dating thing with them.
Right.
But in real life, your teenage daughter, doesn't she have a boyfriend?
She has a boyfriend. Well, she had a boyfriend. She's in Scotland now. We've moved her to a convent right outside of Edinburgh. But her boyfriend, this guy named Tim, who she said he's a very sweet guy at Vassar. He was a German physicist, which right away made me suspicious. And so we were in a car, you know, with Carly's mom and Tim was his name.
This was with an alias.
He had an unfortunate accident.
I know.
But so I said, so you know, Carly's going to be at camp this summer as a wrangler at this camp in the Rocky Mountains, teaching girls from 13 to 16 about horses and everything. I said, what are you going to do this summer, Tim? And he said, well, I think what I'll do is just spend 3 months of drunken debauchery. And I thought, that's not the opening line you want to say to your girlfriend's father. So we had a problem right at the get-go. I don't know if you can say get-go.
No, your four-year-old has fans, right?
Well, she's got a stable. She goes to a preschool, and there are about three or four guys that like her. One guy, doesn't really know the difference between boyfriend and stalker. We're trying to clear that up.
There's a difference? I didn't know that.
Stella!
But wait, I heard that when you once dated a girl who had a father who was very much like you,
well,
he didn't like you at all.
No, he didn't like me because she was a year older than I was in college, and she was dating a guy who was... making, $25,000 a year already right out of grad school, and I was an actor, which was, real bad. Mm. But he would talk to me. He was sort of a pretentious guy, and sir, if you're watching, I don't care. And he'd talk to me like this. He'd go, John, so how's everything going? And then he'd close his eyes, just assuming that I'd be there listening to him. So to drive her crazy and to relax myself, every time he'd close his eyes, I'd go like this. And it just would amuse me because he'd go, John, and I'd be like this. And so every so often he'd open his eyes and I'd be, But anyway, that's...
And now I was...
We're no longer together. Father and I hang, though.
Yeah, you're good, buddy. You must have been quite the rogue, because I heard you were on the dating game in the old days.
I was.
Did you get a date?
Yeah. Who can do the theme song from the dating game?
In 19... Ba, 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 ba. No, that's Hawaii 5-0, sorry.
You're costing us money. You can't do the song.
But you know what? That gets me hot. Actually, I did date Jack Lord on Hawaii 5-0.
Wait, did you win the dating?
It wasn't love. It was just location.
Did you get picked on the dating?
I did get picked, but
you did.
Yes, I
what
did.
What was the thing that made her pick you, do you think?
What makes you think it was a she?
Why, Josh, you devil!
The dating game. No, actually, we got a trip to Lake Havasu, Arizona.
Oh, but, there's a hot spot, yeah.
But the lake was closed.
But the scorpions were out.
Wait, now, did Chuck Barris go with you? Because according to the movie, Yes, it was his show.
Oh, it was?
Yeah, according to his show, I mean, the Confessions of the Dangerous Mind, he was supposed to go out with some of the dates as a chaperone.
Well, Chuck didn't, there wasn't that much spy activity in Lake Havasu. But he went on the trips, the nighttime dating game. They went to Argentina and, you know, Berlin and all of that.
See, so much Nazis?
Huh? Yeah. We have a Swiss.
So now I hear that you were going to host a TV Land award show. Tell us about that.
Well, that's, it's TV Land Awards are going to give awards to people from classic TVs like Don Knotts and Mary Tyler Moore and Dick Van Dyke, my idols. And
well, Three's Company, classic as it gets.
Yeah, well, it's sort of, that just knows its way in there.
Yeah.
There's this guy, you might know him, Bruce Valanche, who's a writer. He's going to shave his beard that he had for 32 years to take over the part in Hairspray. And the first time I met Bruce Valanche was in 1980 when I did a, I don't know if I can say this, Patricia might walk out, but it was...
I'm getting a reputation as national
I love
food.
That. I love
like
that.
You'll be like Tipper Gore pretty soon. Be careful.
Are we late? Oh, the woman's waving at me. You were on the dating game. But Bruce Valanche is this wonderful guy, and he's such a fun guy. So he's writing the show, so I figured that
It'll be great. Yeah. When is it? Do you know?
I have no idea.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
We'll look for it.
All right, thank you. Our thanks to Julianne Moore, and don't forget to watch 8 My Teenage Daughter, Tuesday nights at 8 p.m. right here on ABC.
Yes.
We'll be right back. It's John Ritter.
You'll never think of a yeast infection the same way again. From Monistat comes the One Dose Ovule, a soft gel insert that goes straight to the infection. It's part of the new Monistat One combination pack, which brings you fast relief that starts immediately. Not so with that Diflucan pill, which has to go through your entire system, so relief can take up to 24 hours. The new Monistat One pre-filled Ovule combination pack. The kind of relief you expect from the number one doctor-recommended brand.
I thought that the skin under my arms was something that couldn't be changed.
Between the shaving,
razor burn, it's very embarrassing. Because of Dove, I mean, I don't have to worry anymore.
Dove Deodorant's 1/4 moisturizer gives back what shaving takes away, leaving your underarms smooth and silky.
It's off.
That's the break.
Get your break going with the light, crispy, chocolatey taste of a Kit Kat.
Presenting Medieval Knievel.
Not everything can be as good as the original. But Diet Dr. Pepper is. Diet Dr. Pepper tastes more like regular Dr. Pepper.
Imagine combining the stain-fighting power of Efferdent and freshening power of Listerine. You'd get Efferdent Plus. It's extra fresh, and nothing gets your dentures cleaner. Efferdent Clean, Listerine Fresh.
Ah.
That's Efferdent Plus.
Tried Rolaids lately? It's fruity, smooth, with a taste test-proof Tums can't beat. And extra-strength Rolaids quickly neutralizes 21% more acid than Tums EX. Rolaids spells fast relief with a taste that can't be beat.
Is this for real? 8-hour lip color that won't torture my lips. Endless from L'Oreal. Comfortable 8-hour lip color. No touch-ups, no going dry. Kiss that torture goodbye. Endless by L'Oreal Paris. Because you're worth it.
It's hard to lose your best friend. Especially when it's your son. I pry into his life. He says, I'll never treat my son like this. And I think, if you love him, you will.
If I need a tic-tac. Friendly little 1.5 calorie breakfast.
Tic-tac. For a refreshing twist, try Tic-Tac Lime.
A fan's getting the celebrity treatment and the Shield star Michael Chiklis when The View returns on ABC.
All new tonight on 8 Simple Rules. A dad tries to be cool with his daughter's friends.
Maybe I better make us a pizza run. Rory, you want to tag along?
No. When Cheryl is robbed, it's Homeland Security, according to Jim.
I feel like a prisoner.
Does that make you hot?
How does Bonnie's boss get the wrong impression about her family?
sorry about your husband's cross-dressing problems.
Life of Bonnie, on Less Than Perfect, Trista from The Bachelorette guest stars.
She's a size 4.
All new tonight on ABC.
Wanted something to give me my new life, and I got it. 78 pounds later, you can't even begin to describe how it was when you first went in there because you feel fabulous.
LA Weight Loss. Losing weight has never been this easy.
You eat a lot in the beginning, and you think, there's no way I'm losing weight. And you get on the scale, and it goes down. LA Weight Loss did it for me.
LA Weight Loss Centers. Call for your free consultation. 1-800-LA-6-SLIM.
Tammy the mom and Tammy the homemaker are very busy. This is my problem with the Glad Wrap. It doesn't stick on a wood bowl. Saran quick covers.
This bowl is an unusual shape.
Wow, it's snug. It's quick, it covers, and I think they should call it, wow, Saran quick covers.
It is about balancing our choices between the concrete jungle and the real one. It's why EarthShare brings the leading environmental groups together. Support EarthShare, support them all. To learn more, please visit our website.
Wow, here you go. You're doing so good.
Well, there he is. Come to Grandpa. Come on. That's a good boy.
You're doing so well.
I wish Grandpa could see you.
Wake up to News 10 in the morning, now starting at 5.
Welcome back, everyone. I want you to take a look at this beautiful woman. Her name is Nancy Ann Mount, and she is from Gilbert, West Virginia. She sent us this tape during our Be Barber for a Day contest, but we had other plans for Nancy. We wanted to take a fan to Los Angeles and give her the full celebrity treatment. And Nancy Ann is as far from Hollywood as you can get. She's even a relative of the Hatfields, as in the Hatfields and the McCoys. So we got celebrity fashion designer Randolph Duke to take Nancy to California and give her the complete celeb overhaul at the Ritz-Carlton. And we're gonna top it off with a big Hollywood premiere with Fabio as her escort. We spared no expense. Let's get started. Please welcome celebrity fashion designer Randolph Duke. Hi, sweetheart. All right. I have to start this off by first asking you about the new reality show.
All right, here we go.
Are you hot? Rachel Hunter. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you said that because you on the show with me. Right. You, Rachel Hunter, and Lorenzo Lamas. And I'm annoyed with y'all already, I'm telling you.
Oh, yeah, it's that laser.
That laser. Yeah. All right, I want to shove that laser right you know where. Yeah. Oh, so are you ever comfortable critiquing people on hotness?
It's never easy to critique people, let's face it. It's always difficult. But in this case, these people think they're hot, and they go out there in bikinis. So this is about putting yourself on a stage saying, I'm hot, and it's all in good fun.
And if you wear a bikini, you on your own.
I got you, baby.
I want to talk about Nancy Ann. Now, you were there for the entire celebrity treatment. So tell us a little bit about her.
Well, I could see when I first met Nancy that she was really in need of some pampering. You know, Nancy's taking care of her husband, who's been sick for 13 years.
And
it's really hard for her. She runs a restaurant, and she's there 12 hours a day. She has a fabulous southern restaurant in West Virginia, so she cooks for 12 hours a day. And then she goes to the hospital for 12 hours a day to be with her husband. So she really, you could see it. You could just see it in her face that she needed a lift, she needed some pampering. So this was a wonderful, wonderful,
wonderful
thing
gift
for her.
To give to her,
Wonderful.
Well, and we also wanted to see her at a restaurant and some of her fabulous cooking. I think we had a little clip or a little picture of her,
let's see that.
This is our famous kitchen that we cook our world's best fried chicken in. It's the world's best to me. We got our own special recipe, and this is about what we do every day.
Okay.
I love that.
Isn't that fabulous?
Let's see what you did. Yeah.
Let's go right to it. Let's see that I missed the chicken. What's this? Okay.
Hey, Nancy.
Hi.
So good to meet you.
So good to see you.
I'm dying to meet you. Well, welcome to fabulous Ritz-Carlton in Los Angeles. What about this place, huh?
Oh, it's fabulous.
Magnificent, huh?
It really is.
What a beautiful day.
Beautiful.
Well, we have the ultimate celebrity makeover plan for you today. Are you ready for it?
Yes, I'm ready.
We've got the full nine yards. We've got the pedicures and manicures and massages and colorists and makeup and right here, all the goodies we're going to try on to make you look absolutely spectacular for the premiere you're going to tonight.
I'll feel like a movie star.
You will. Are you ready for this celebrity transformation?
Absolutely.
All right, well, let's get started.
So, Nancy, now that you're about to have your big celebrity makeover, what do you think the folks back home are going to think about all of this?
Oh, they're not going to believe this when they see me on TV.
They're not, huh?
No.
What did they say before you left?
Well, they all cried and told me not to go. I'd probably get killed here.
Killed?
Yeah.
This is Anthony. I'm going to put him in your...
Glad to meet you.
You in his hands, you're going to be in great shape.
How nice.
Excellent. Nancy, when's the last time you had a massage?
In the 70s, on a cruise ship. We went a trip, and just for curiosity, I went for a massage, and it was very nice. I was embarrassed, but I really enjoyed it.
Excellent. Let's get you going.
Massage was great. It helped me get rid of the stress, and it was so relaxing. I could handle one of those every day.
You're here with the fabulous stylist, hairstylist to the stars, Frankie Payne. He's done with Rachel Griffiths. He's done with Justin Timberlake, just to name a couple. And today, he's going to make you look fantastic.
Today, I'm going to be using TRESemmé products on you. It gives you that salon celebrity feeling, but you can get it at the drugstore. This TRESemmé Intense Moisture Conditioner and Shampoo is going to make your hair look so shiny and luxurious.
This is Lori Goddard. She's the colors to the stars. She's done Meg Ryan, Raquel Welch, and even Madonna. So you know you're in good hands. Lori, take it away.
Thank you, Randolph.
This is Sylvia from the Ritz-Carlton Spa. She's going to do your... Oh, my God.
Oh, no.
Get your work cut out for
you. I sure do.
Manicure and pedicure coming up.
I love the color. It made me feel like Goldie Hawn. I think she's got such a pretty color of hair.
So, Nancy, I'm putting the TRESemmé Moisture Gel in your hair. This is going to give you that sexy, tousled look. And it's going to add a lot of body and shape and shine without drying your hair out.
There's not a famous eyebrow in Hollywood that hasn't been touched by Anastasia. She's done Jennifer Lopez. She's done famous, famous people.
After this consultation, you will know really how to shape your eyebrow perfectly. You will look like a movie star every single day. If this is tiring for you, believe me, it's tiring for them. They wake up at 4 o'clock in the morning to get ready for the Oscar, so you have to know how it feels.
Oh, I love the eyebrows. It made my eyes look so much bigger, I think. And it's much easier to do. I always pluck them, and she just took that stuff and zapped it right off.
This is Brett Friedman.
Hello there.
Makeup artist.
How are
to
you?
The stars. He's done Melanie Griffith, and he's done Gwyneth Paltrow. Two other fabulous blondes.
It's good. We just have to make sure it's really even, and we don't have any mud clumps on our heels.
That's your daughter calling from West Virginia. Here she is.
Amber. Oh, God, you should see me. They're doing everything to me. I've had everything, even my toes manicured.
Nancy, I have a surprise. Sorry to interrupt, Brett, but I've got $1 million worth of diamonds from Fred Layton just for you today. Incredible rose-cut diamonds, chandelier earrings, deco bracelets. How incredible. And look at this incredible necklace here.
My family's going to die when they see me.
Now, Saks Fifth Avenue has given me all these fabulous clothes that I selected for you. These are wonderful pieces, and you're going to get to keep whatever you pick today to wear.
Sweet. So. Oh, the celebrity makeover means a lot to me because I never take time for myself, and it's certainly been fun to do and see the results. Fabio, here I come.
Tune in tomorrow to see Nancy's new celebrity look and then watch her strut the red carpet. You will not believe the celebrity she bumps into. That was Patricia Heaton's makeup artist. We'll be right back.
Kids get sick. It happens all the time.
That's why at the Medicine Shop Pharmacy, we spend all of our time helping parents care for family. We're dedicated solely to your family's health. So rest assured, no matter what the problem, when there's a cure, we'll be there for you. They depend on you. You can depend on us. The Medicine Shop.
This is Ocean Spray White Cranberry, a delicious, less tart taste made with all-natural white cranberries. Ocean Spray White Cranberry. Crave the wave.
Run your fingers through your hair. Shampoo with Pantene and feel the difference. The Pro-V formula with extra moisturizers makes it softer, silkier, weightless in 10 days. Shampoo with Pantene and feel the softness.
He was amazing.
And covered in this thick, dark stuff.
Look, that's it.
No, this had chips.
Chips Ahoy cookie bars, stuffed with chocolate cream, drenched in fudge, unlike anything you've ever experienced. They're beyond belief.
Sometimes when we turn, the honesty is too much, and I have to close my eyes and hide.
Why do people love Geico?
I want to hold you till I die, till we both break down.
Because 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Till the fear in me subsides.
Come on, you can do it. Just 30 seconds of Listerine. Think of all the germs you're killing. Listerine even kills the germs that can cause plaque and gingivitis. See? You can handle it. Germs can't. Listerine. Worth the time, every time.
What's the softest bath tissue for your little ones? Not this stuff. Not anymore. Because there's softer Charmin Ultra. It's stronger than the quilted stuff, even when wet. Charmin Ultra. Anything less is unbearable.
Cha-cha-cha. Charmin.
Try new Charmin Fresh Mix Cloths in a tub.
Wet.
Means fresher.
Fact. Tough stains are easier to get rid of than the in-laws. Fact. New Orange Breeze Lysol Scrubbing Wipes with built-in scrubbing fibers are the best because they simply clean better. Life demands Lysol. That's a fact.
Any school nurse what kinds of problems cold, dry, winter weather brings on, and chances are she'll tell you nosebleeds. Hi, I'm Tracy Egan. In Medical Breakthroughs, how to prevent them, myths about them, and how to treat bloody noses.
Sit up and pinch for 5 minutes by the clock.
Medical Breakthroughs with Tracy Egan, tonight on News 10 at 5:30.
Now, the future of weather forecasting comes straight to your computer with the News 10 Personal Storm Tracker. Sign up today at WTEN.com.
You may think you know Michael Chiklis from his hit show, The Commish, but if you haven't seen him in his new award-winning show, The Shield, where he plays one tough, unconventional cop, then you don't know Michael Chiklis like I know Michael Chiklis. Take a look.
Put your hand in here.
Yeah.
Póngame lo aquí.
Do it. I'm getting a train. No.
Armadillo, ¿dónde está? ¿Dónde?
Lo voy a echar en una casa allá por...
¿Dónde?
En la joya chica. La joya chica. Well?
He says he's in some house in the Little Jewel.
He has a perfect shaped head. Please welcome Michael Chiklis.
Julianne,
you look more.
You know, it's funny because ever since Ray won an Emmy, he also wears a wig. Yes.
Well, you know, I'm up for two Oscars. Yeah.
You look more like Nicole Kidman, which you look, to be honest with you.
I'm here really to speak about my favorite show.
Which is?
The Shield.
Very good.
He does have a nice shape.
Doesn't he?
It's a C-section baby. Do I have wig head now? No, you don't have wig head. No, I don't have wig head. No wig head. Great. Do you know what she said? No, it's a C-section baby. Oh, see that? No, 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 no Socialized medicine. We were 14 hours into labor when the guy went, "Oh, that's a bum, eh?" And breech. Wow. And I was like, "You're finding this out now?" And the thing is, you get to be in the room during a C-section there, which I don't think you can do here.
Not an emergency one, but if it's...
It was an emergency one. That's an interesting thing to watch your wife...
Your husband can film it and then show it to lots of people.
Yes, that's annoying.
It's always nice.
You know, Michael, let's talk about you, because you... congratulations on all your success.
Yeah.
You're
You won an Emmy.
Really?
You brought the Emmy.
First of all, if I was depressed at this point in my life, I'd have to hit the couch in a big way, because I mean, it's just been an embarrassment of riches this year. It really has been extraordinary. And when I won the Emmy, I went to my daughter's school the next morning. We did a show and tell. I have a 9-year-old daughter named Autumn, my beautiful one, and she's actually plays my daughter in the Shield, though she's not allowed to actually watch the show, which is frustrating for her. So I took the Emmy to this class, and I had them pass it around. And here I am trying to give them some sort of life lesson. You know, I'm talking to them about how, you know, if they dream about something and they work really hard, I was only their age when I started acting, and that they could achieve their dreams in some way. And one of the kids grabs the Emmy and says, "How much do you think we could get for this on eBay?" That kid's gonna be an executive. No question.
Now listen, didn't I audition for you once?
I
auditioned for him and I didn't get the job.
But not because she wasn't incredibly talented. I was actually worried that you'd have staged me.
No, actually Raymond came along and I took that job.
Yeah, see that? Well, actually, you actually had a deal memo for them at the same time.
I did. I'm just giving you some stick.
Embarrassment of riches for the both of you. Yeah. I understand your wife was actually the one who pushed you to go out for the Shield.
Well,
and turn you from the soft, loving, cuddly man that we all fell in love with to this lean, mean fighting machine.
Well, she, you know, actors go through frustrating times, and you know what's inside of you, you know what you can do, and I knew that I could reinvent myself, but my wife was the one who said to me, "Look, Michael, it's not up to an executive at some studio to reinvent you. It's up to you to do the work and reinvent yourself." So, I mean, she's just been nothing but encouraging and magnificent.
You're just adorable. I just think you're very handsome also.
Mm-hmm.
You have it all, Michael. Nobody deserves the success more than
Absolutely.
You do. And we love the show.
Watch it tonight, Tuesday nights, 10 o'clock.
Women love
this. Yes, they do. They love his head. Thanks to Michael Chiklis. Be sure to check out The Shield on FX every Tuesday night. We'll be right back.
The View from L.A. is brought to you by Tresemme. Professional. Affordable. Tresemme.
Millions of women can afford to use professional hair care products thanks to Tresemme. Professional products without the salon price.
You don't have to spend a fortune for professional quality. Try Tresemme Natural Shampoo and Conditioner with 100% natural extracts and now twice the vitamins A, C, and E. Keeps hair strong and healthy.
Tresemme. Professional, affordable Tresemme.
When you have acid reflux disease, heartburn boils up again and again.
As bad as the heartburn can be, the real threat is what lies beneath.
Over time, that burning acid could wear away the lining of your esophagus. And even if your heartburn symptoms aren't severe, the damage can be.
I didn't know. I didn't know.
Your doctor knows about a purple pill called Nexium. Nexium goes to the source of the problem, actually reducing the amount of acid your body creates.
For many people, one prescription Nexium a day provides complete 24-hour...
day and night heartburn relief.
And importantly, Nexium is proven to heal acid reflux erosions in the esophagus. Other serious stomach conditions may still exist. The most common side effects of Nexium are headache, diarrhea, and abdominal pain. Talk to your doctor and call this number for more information and a free trial offer for Nexium.
Relieve the heartburn, heal the damage. It's possible with the purple pill called Nexium.
This mess calls for brawny.
Only brawny paper towels have scrubbing circles for scrubbing strength. Brawny, it might be too strong.
Aha! So it's you, Dad.
Give me a minute to make my case.
Kool-Aid, stir up some smiles.
Okay, Dad, case dismissed.
Where'd that come from?
I don't know, but it's giving me
a cramp. For a limited time, you can get a free Disney read-along DVD inside any specially marked box of Kellogg's Disney cereals, part of this complete breakfast.
I can't take this much.
Ask your doctor today if Lipitor is right for you.
Choosing a tampon isn't about gimmicks. It's about wearing comfort. And nothing beats Playtex Gentle Glide tampons for that. No pads, no other tampons, nothing. Playtex tampons. So comfortable, you can't even feel them. Guaranteed.
Don't you just love that morning fresh makeup look?
Maybelline invents Everfresh makeup. Looks morning fresh, stays put. Day to night. New Everfresh Stay Put Makeup by Maybelline.
You'll look morning fresh, day to night.
Achy joints, this is my Flexamine, and this is my grandson.
Achy joints, this is my Flexamine, and this is my garden.
Get the relief your joints have been aching for. Maximum Strength Flexamine, formulated by Arthritis Research Corporation, soothes and lubricates achy joints and promotes flexibility with regular use.
This is our Flexamine.
And this is our life.
Make it your Flexamine. Look for the box with the flashing red light wherever quality vitamins are sold.
They're on the run.
I'm gonna kill her right in front of his eyes.
From a vow of revenge.
The only way this is gonna be over is if he kills me or I kill him. I'm gonna need to get you someplace safe.
Paradise can turn deadly.
Don't come any closer. He wired the cooler so that if I even move, it will blow.
All My Children, ABC Daytime. You just can't get enough.
Get real with reality TV's hottest stars. The Bachelorette and her bachelors, American Idol wannabes, stranded celebrities, and all the reasons why we love this stuff. This week on Good Morning America.
Thanks to Patricia Heaton and her perky breasts, you can catch all of them on Everybody Loves Raymond on Monday nights. And her book, Motherhood in Hollywood, will be out in paperback in April. And Julianne Moore, she was terrific.
Well, she's awesome.
She'll learn The View from L.A. Dr. Phil, until then, enjoy The View.
Get me out of here.
The treachery begins Wednesday on ABC.
Coming up on News 10 at noon, Capital Region residents are digging out from another winter wallop. Dozens of people are dead following a massive fire aboard a South Korean subway.
And I'll have a recap on President's Day storm number 2 to tell you how much the area got and what's in store for the next couple of days.
And we're cooking pasta and chicken in the kitchen with our guest chef. It's all next on News 10 at noon.
Clam chowder?
Yeah.
Me too. What was that look for?
Well, the clams in my Campbell Select are more tender than yours. And Campbell Select beat Progresso in a taste test. Want to taste the winner?
Campbell Select. Pepperidge Farm Texas Toast.
Okay, I'll get the pasta bowl.
It's a silverware.
Hot, crusty garlic toast. Just 5 minutes to make. It's probably ready before you are. Pepperidge Farm. Never have an ordinary day.
For a limited time, when you buy one ticket on Amtrak, your companion goes free. That's buy one, get one, and everyone's happy. Call 1-800-USA-RAIL today. Then relax, because the second one's free.
Judge Judy, today at 4 on WTEN.
Live
From WTEN in Albany, this is News 10 at noon.
Snowblowers moving a foot or two of snow dumped by last night's storm, keeping people in the capital region busy. Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Tracy Egan. The powerful President's Day storm paralyzed eastern seaboard cities before swinging north into the capital region. It met expectations, dropping 1 to 2 feet of snow across our viewing area. But we were lucky on several counts. It's dry, fluffy snow, and it stopped falling overnight, so that snow plows were able to push a great deal of it off the highways by daybreak. Now, if we can just clear off our sidewalks and driveways and clear the snow off the roof before it does any damage, we may not have such harsh memories after all of the President's Day storm of 03. Let's turn to meteorologist Andy Gregorio to find out if this latest snow will blow away, melt, or linger.
How about lingering, Tracy? Looks like we're going to see temperatures a little bit near normal over the next couple of days, but not enough warmth to melt the snow. Let's take a look at President's Day storm that moved up along the eastern seaboard and what it did. Tell you what, the Northeast Corridor got Baltimore, a record-breaking snowstorm of 26.6 inches, 18 inches in Philadelphia, New York City, Central Park, almost 20 inches, their fourth heaviest snow, down in Orange County, 30 inches at Monroe, Bradley Field, Windsor Locks, Connecticut, 16 inches of snow here in Albany, 12.9, and how about Boston, a record-breaking 27.5 inches of snow, their heaviest on record. Some local snow totals: Troy, 10 inches, Pownell, 7, Marlborough at 14. Look at the Berkshires. They got hammered, 24 at Florida, 18 at Savoy. Ancrum down in southern Columbia County, 15 inches, and Windham, 22. Off to the north and west, snowfall amounts tapered off, 10 inches, Warrensburg, Whitehall, 13, and 12-inch amounts from Glens Falls and Malta, respectively. Not too much in eastern Washington County, as predicted. We said Sioux would be shadowed out, and they were at 2.5 inches, and in the southern Adirondacks, Paseco at 1.5 inches, while Alplaus came in with 14. So all in all, pretty much lived up to expectations, that storm. The good news is it's over and done with. The bad news is we have a lot of wintry weather heading our way, and I'll have the details on that in my full weather in a few minutes. Tracy?
All right, Andy, thanks. Well, things are getting back to normal at Albany International Airport, where yesterday's snowfall caused several flight cancellations. A few stranded travelers even spent the night. Tanisha Millett is live at Albany International with the latest. Tanisha?
Well, many of those cancellations spilled into this morning, and according to Doug Myers, a spokesperson here at the airport, those cancellations are close to being over, and they are definitely back to normal. But after some of the sad faces I saw this morning, all you can say is what a difference a few hours make. Workers were clearing the way for early morning passengers at Albany International Airport. Too bad the rest of the morning wasn't so smooth. Airport officials say 16 flights were canceled this morning because of the snowstorm. Doris Moon of Queensbury has been stuck at the airport since 7 a.m. yesterday morning.
So what have you been doing since you've been waiting around?
Walking around, going up to the coffee shop, and just walking. Reading a lot, reading.
Moon is trying to visit her daughter in Norfolk, Virginia. Only problem, she has a layover in Baltimore, an airport that's still closed. It seems that's what's causing the problem.
What has happened in Baltimore and Washington is those airports closed for a long period of time, and Baltimore is still closed, we understand, until around 4 o'clock this afternoon. Those are hubs, and when a hub closes, it has the ripple effect of falling back on everybody, and everybody pays the price for that.
Meantime, Moon waits patiently but gets some encouraging news from Southwest Airlines.
She said yesterday it looked good if I was the first one in line for the 9:30 flight. So I am the first one in line for standby at 9:30.
What's more, around 9 o'clock this morning, Southwest Airlines, which operates 7 flights to Baltimore, reroutes some of those flights to other cities, including Norfolk, Virginia, just in time for that 9:30 flight. And after waiting more than 24 hours for this moment, Moon says it was no big deal.
It's just something that happened. You can't control Mother Nature, and I'm used to sitting around waiting for things, so it's just one of those things. And with the world the way it is, people have to be patient. Life's too short.
Doug Meyer says that Moon was one of only 3 people that stayed in the airport terminal overnight. They were prepared with cots and blankets for much more, but only 3 people took them up on that offer. Again, Baltimore Washington International Airport, the main airport in Baltimore, Maryland, expected to be closed until 4 p.m. So if you have a flight that's going to take you through there, or D.C. for that matter, please call ahead. Those could be some of the lingering cancellations later on today. Reporting to you live from Albany International Airport, Tanisha Millett, News 10.
I think we could all use a little bit of Doris Moon's patience. Thanks, yes. Tanisha. 2 teen skiers this noon are lost at Killington Ski Resort in Vermont. Alex and Ed Ursa were reported missing at 7 o'clock last night. State police there are working with search and rescue teams to find the teens. Ski Week travelers from Washington to Boston have been stranded by this storm. New York City recorded its fourth highest snowfall ever. Central Park saw 20 inches of snow. LaGuardia Airport reopened about an hour ago. In the nation's capital, most local government offices are still closed. In all, the blizzard caused about 20 deaths, including one person who died when a roof collapsed in New Jersey. On top of that death toll, in Baltimore, two children have died and a third is hospitalized after being found in a snow-covered car. A neighbor discovered the children early this morning. It's unknown at this time who's responsible for those children or how long they were in the car. The children ranged in age from 10 to 14. The United Nations begins debate on Iraq today. Talks will focus around a new resolution proposed by the U.S. and Britain, endorsing the use of force against Iraq. President Bush says he won't be deterred by global protests against war with Iraq. British Prime Minister Tony Blair agrees, saying the Iraqi crisis goes hand in hand with the fight against terrorism.
The stance that the world takes now against Saddam is not just vital in its own right. It is a huge test of our seriousness in dealing with the twin threats of weapons of mass destruction and terrorism. These are threats best dealt with by a unified international community.
The UN Security Council has resisted authorizing the use of military force, but France is now downplaying a threat that it will use its veto. In South Korea, more than 100 people are dead after a man deliberately set off a massive fire aboard a subway in South Korea. The death toll is expected to grow because several people are still missing, and many of the bodies were so badly burned, it may be weeks before a DNA test can confirm the exact number of fatalities. Nathan Thomas reports from London.
When firemen rushed down into the smoky subway station, they didn't know how bad it was. As they fought through the thick smoke, they started finding people who had almost escaped. We saw several people unconscious on the stairs, said this fireman. We rescued them first. Many of those brought out were badly burned and suffering from smoke inhalation. Many were already dead. Some firemen made dozens of trips down into the smoke-filled station and told of a horrible scene. There were white bones and burned belongings scattered on the floor, said one fireman. Everything that could burn did. As many as 600 passengers had been on two trains in the station when a man tried to light a milk carton filled with flammable liquid, said survivors. When passengers tried to stop him, the carton burst into flames. The man believed to have started the fire was treated in the hospital with other victims. He's under arrest, and police say he has a history of mental illness. During the 3 hours it took to put the fire out, worried relatives gathered near the subway entrance. Many had received frantic cell phone calls from those caught in the flame. My daughter was on the subway on her way to a lesson, said this man. She called when the fire broke out. No word on whether she survived. Many are still missing. Nathan Thomas, ABC News.
Authorities in Chicago are threatening to seek charges against the operator of a nightclub where 21 people were trampled to death. Police say the club had been ordered to shut down because of safety violations, including failure to provide enough exits. A lawyer for the club owner says his client had a deal to keep the club open, and he claims the city knew the club was operating. Coming up here on News 10 at noon, a quiet forecast until the end of the week. Andy has details next. Then in my medical breakthroughs report, a new procedure is helping stroke patients.
Tonight on News 10 at 5. Every parent has heard that timeless complaint. There's nothing to do. Tanisha Millett found plenty of places in the capital region that can rid your kids of that winter break boredom.
Theaters, plays, and read-ins can be a great way to keep your kids entertained.
Kids Vacation Week with Tanisha Millett, tonight on News 10 at 5.
Looking to save big bucks on some great-looking bedroom furniture? Then you need to head for Bedroom Expressions President's Day's 18-month no-interest savings event, which means not only will you get incredible bargains on some incredibly styled bedroom furniture, you'll also get no interest for 18 months. That's no interest until August 2004. Now's the time to roll into Bedroom Expressions. Our 18 months no-interest finance offer ends Tuesday, February 18th. Next to Oak Express.
It's a monumental savings event.
The killer could be you.
his own son. Then, a madman returns from the dead to get revenge.
I got you right where I want you.
Two big stories, one big twist. In 1 week, you'll know who the killer is.
Just tell me.
Murder at Midnight, Days of Our Lives.
Sunday, an NBC movie event. They were just married, but one by one, they're being killed.
Neither one is wearing a wedding band. Taking the rings could be his signature. He's gonna kill again.
Now the hunt begins.
They were both shot at close range.
For the honeymoon killer.
I know who you are, and I know what you did.
From the best-selling novel by James Patterson.
Oh, God.
Tracy Pollan, First to Die. NBC Sunday, 8, 7 Central.
Tom Brokaw, live from the Mideast. NBC 90 News, all this week.
Coming up today on News Channel 13, live at 5.
It's become a familiar sight this winter, snow and lots of it. We're going to take a look at how it's affecting travelers at the Albany International Airport. And how is the rest of the East Coast dealing with the record-breaking snowfalls? Also, radio waves easing the pain of TMJ. I'll tell you how it works. It's in my Check of Healthy Living right after Oprah. Plus, we'll have the latest on the search for two teenage boys who disappeared while skiing in Vermont, live at 5.
At Leah Hyundai, we're heating up with some of the hottest deals in town. Brand new 2003 Exits for just $163 a month with zero down or pay just $94.90. Get a 2003 Elantra GLS for just $188 a month or pay $10,995. Step into a 2003 Sonata GLS for just $259 a month or pay just $15,193. Leah Hyundai has rows of Santa Fe, Tiburons, XT350s, and pre-owned vehicles available. Stop in today and take advantage of these hot deals at Leah Hyundai, located at 945 Central Avenue. Call 458-CARS.
Thinking of making a move? Then go to JobsTU. With 5 ways to search, it's the Capital Region's biggest, broadest, and best job marketplace. Pick up a Times Union or go online today. JobsTU, your best way to work.
I'll go. All right, you two, that's enough goofing around.
I think I'm afraid.
Time to turn out the lights.
Wait, Mom, I just got to the best part.
This moment brought to you by Sylvan Learning Center.
I never liked reading, and Sylvan showed me how fun it can be.
We call our approach the Sylvan Advantage. It's individual attention from highly trained and certified teachers, plus progress reports for you.
Call 1-800-EDUCATE for the Sylvan Learning Center nearest you.
Hi, I'm Dick Wood. Seems this winter caught everyone off guard, except quick response restoration. Images like these can be frightening, but if you suffered ice or water damage, rest easy. Quick response will live up to their name, assessing the damage quickly and professionally restoring everything good as new. What's the rest of the winter have in store? I'll leave that to the experts. You should leave your restoration work to the experts at Quick Response. I did. Call 899-7090. You'll find their ad on the back of your phone book.
You're watching WNYT, Albany.
Today on Dr. Phil, all these people have a bone to pick with one guy, me. Spanking is not okay.
Couple of little whacks, gets right into focus.
If somebody that I love is inflicting pain on me, I'm just like, hey, go love somebody else.
I'm not gonna let you tell me that being single is some sort of failure in my life.
If you want a man and you ain't got one, what is it you're defending? You need to do an autopsy on your relationships.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
You decide what size you have to be to look good.
So you're saying I'm not sure who ought to decide that, but it damn sure ain't Phil.
That's right.
Coming up.
Let's do it.
I want you to get excited about your life.
If you're going to talk to me, you're going to have to be honest. This is going to be a changing day in your life. For today, all of my guests today say they have a bone to pick with one guy, me.
Yeah, well, I'm easy to find, okay? They say some of the things I've said have really ticked them off, and they want to tell me like it is. So today, we're turning the tables, and viewers are going to get a chance to debate with me. Now, hope we have a little extra security in the studio today. You have to be nice to me today because my mom's here today. So, stand up, Grandma. That's my mother from Dallas. We call her Grandma, so. But not because you look like a grandma. All right, my first challenger is Stacia. She's 5'1", 250 pounds, and she says she's fat and happy and can't understand why I keep telling people like her to lose weight, why I keep telling people like her that you can't be fat and happy. Take a look at the tape.
My name is Stacia. I love the Dr. Phil show. I would love to challenge Dr. Phil on the fact that you can be fat and happy.
I weigh a little over 400 pounds, and I'm perfectly happy. Today, I've absolutely accepted myself for who I am. I know that I matter, and I know that I mean a great deal to other people.
Marilyn, is there a difference between saying, I'm glad that I weigh what I weigh, I'm happy about this, and saying, I accept it?
I accept the weight, and I am profoundly happy in my life because of the other things that I've chosen to do.
And he came on with his opinion that you could not have a good body image and be happy if you were overweight. I could not believe that that was what he was actually saying because I thought that was so ridiculous.
Because I'm telling you, I don't think y'all should weigh what you weigh. I think that you should not do that. I think it's got health repercussions. You can have a self-image that is fully happy, fully functioning, fully developed, and be a huge contributor to society and all, and have a body image that is not in the same place.
From a very young age, food was always the enemy. My father is the type of person who, as a teenager, if I weighed 105 pounds, he'd tell me, if you lose 5 more pounds, I'll buy you a new wardrobe. I don't agree with my doctor saying that I need to lose weight, because when you can show me that it's going to make a difference, then I would be more apt to believe that. Being thin does not guarantee me a long life, so I'm happy where I am.
When I look at you, I do have a reaction, and my reaction is I see danger.
I would rather die at 70 eating chocolate cake and having a steak than live to 80 and eat carrot sticks and celery. I really feel I'm a sexy, vibrant, incredible human being, and I don't think you can say that overweight people cannot be happy with what they look like. Size has nothing to do with that.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
All right, so your theory is that you can be, in your words, fat and happy. The two don't have anything to do with each other.
Yeah.
And you completely disagree with my, was it ridiculous position? Was
ridiculous.
That ridiculous position.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So let's talk about that. You, what is it precisely that I said that you disagree with?
I think that body image does not have anything to do with your size. I know plenty of people who are extraordinarily thin and have horrible body images. I know people who are right in the middle that have terrible body images. And who is it that decides exactly what size you have to be to look good? I feel like I look good now. When I was very thin, I thought I looked terrible. So, you know, who is it that decides that my body image has to be a certain size in order for me to feel good?
So you're saying I'm not sure who ought to decide that, but it damn sure ain't Phil?
That's right.
I'm helping you here. I'm helping you make your argument. Trust me. Trust me. All right, and so you didn't like me saying people can't be fat and happy.
That's right.
Well, you know, it's interesting that you say, so you watched the show.
Yeah.
Start to finish.
Mm-hmm.
On your TV.
Well, I have 3 kids, so I mean, you know, there are moments where I have to separate them.
Don't start moonwalking on me now, girl. I don't be laying it off on your kids. I said quite the contrary. I said body image and self-image don't matter. They're not connected. The fact that one is good and the other is bad can be completely two independent
mm-hmm. positions. I covered several specific myths in the mm-hmm. show about overweight people. Let's take a look at the one that is particularly on point. Fat people are always unhappy being fat. I don't believe that at all. Right. I think some people, I think they're happy in spite of it instead of because of it. Did you miss that part?
No, I understood that. I guess my thought on that was that my life is not going to be more fulfilled being thin. I'm not happy in, you know, I don't feel in spite of being fat. I don't think it really happy has anything to do with it. So I guess, and maybe I missed your point, but the point is that I felt like it wasn't that I'm happy, and it doesn't have anything to do with fat, not fat, you know, funny, you know, it's just nothing to do with it.
What? Do you do that with your husband? If you're losing an argument, you start going, well, I think it just kind of goes here and there and everywhere, and oh, well, never mind. Does
no,
that work for you?
Right.
Does that work for you in Houston? Because that don't work for you here.
Yeah. No, he doesn't argue with me.
And I think your main point in argument was, I don't like mustaches, so how can he be happy and wear a mustache?
Well, I said, I think attractive is different to different people, and that there are many people who don't find overweight being attractive, but I don't find mustaches attractive. So it's different for everybody, you know?
Well, you know what? You shouldn't wear a mustache then. Okay? You shouldn't wear a mustache. I don't. Now, you also said something that I thought was interesting. You said your dad always dogged on you. Mm-hmm. So I wonder if you're happy about your weight or if you're rebelling against your dad.
Well, no, I'm happy with
God, I hate it when I sound like a shrink. I'm actually talking to this woman about her father.
Well, I just felt as though that you do and you did cover these myths. But I did feel like some of your point was that that you have a certain reaction when you see someone that is overweight and that you feel like they shouldn't weigh what they weigh. And I felt like that's your opinion.
Well, we always find something in every dispute that we can agree on. Mm-hmm. And we can agree on that point. What I said was to this woman, I do have a reaction when I see people that are overweight. Mm-hmm. And what I see is danger. Mm-hmm. I don't see unhappiness, I see danger. Mm-hmm. You know, you said, I would rather eat what I want and live to 70 instead of eat what I'm supposed to and live till I'm 80. And let me tell you something. Your opinion on that would probably change the day before your 70th birthday. You said if I knew that it really made a difference, it might, because you said there's nothing wrong with me. My doctor keeps wanting me to lose weight, but there's nothing wrong with me.
Well, I do not have any health issues. I do not have diabetes. I do not have high blood pressure. I do not have any of these things. So there.
Oh, but you do.
But I don't.
But you do. I slipped into your room last night and did a physical on you. No. You do. And let me tell you what. And I did a little simple math today. Do you know that at your height, weight, and age, I did the math today mm-hmm. with my medical consultants. Mm-hmm. who are board certified in all of the things that you're just describing, and they tell me at your height and weight, your heart is having to pump your blood an extra 750 miles per week in order to service your body with you being overweight. Mm-hmm. Now, that totals up to 39,000 miles a year, mm-hmm. and across 25 years, that heart is going to have to pump your blood an extra 1 million miles. Now, I don't know if you know much about pumps, but pumps wear out. Mm-hmm. And if you're going to have to pump yours an extra 1 million miles over the next 25 years, doesn't logic tell you that that should be considered, that that's an extra load on your heart that probably doesn't make common sense? And you have these beautiful children. Don't you think you ought to take better care of their mom and her heart, if in fact what I'm saying is true?
The sacrifices that I would have to make at this point in time to be at the ideal weight, okay, would require me to do a lot of things that I'm not willing to do right now.
Okay, and that's your choice. I just want you to take care of yourself from a medical standpoint, and that's my story, and I'm sticking to it. All right. Okay, coming up, to spank or not to spank your kids. A family challenges my belief that spanking does more harm than good. We're going to get into this debate, to spank or not. We'll be right back. You did a good job.
We have three children, and we spanked all three children.
I didn't enjoy it, but that's the whole point of being spanked, and I intend to do that for my son now.
Introducing a new overnight laxative, Freelax. These contain stimulants that can jolt your system and cause cramps. Freelax is different. It's stimulant-free and cramp-free. It's new, different. It's Freelax.
Overnight relief without cramps. Freelax.
We're pulling over a plumber's truck.
Sir, step out of the truck, please.
Is there a problem, officer?
Keep your hands down there, sweetheart.
Well, well, well. This is suspicious. But I'm a plumber, so what's a plumber doing with professional strength liquid plumber clog remover?
I admit it, I've used it on backup sinks.
That's pretty serious.
Oh, yeah, you pour it in, it's like a missile. It cuts right through the water to deliver some serious power to that clog. Ow, clog's gone.
Professional strength liquid plumber on tough clogs. Don't get caught without it.
Donuts? That's not funny.
Wishing for a miracle to solve your every hair need?
I believe in miracles!
Try Pantene Pro-V Complete Therapy Conditioners. The complete pro-vitamin formula transforms frizzy hair into silky smooth, weak into strong, and dull into shiny. Not a miracle, but close.
I believe in miracles!
Give Pantene 10 days and you'll believe it too. Complete Therapy Conditioners. Pantene Hair. That's the beauty of health.
I believe in miracles!
It's hard to describe the flavor of Welch's white grape juice. So, I just follow my taste. Mmm, fruity, tarty, sweet, and tangy. And Welch's has so many different flavors. I haven't tried them all yet, but I'm very good at following my taste.
For over 65 years, people have trusted the Culligan man for quality water. He's always had a full line of products to fit any budget. And now, for a limited time, he's offering no money down, no interest, and no payments for 6 months on water softeners, whole house filters, and drinking water systems. With great financing and a 100% satisfaction guarantee, there's never been a better time for great water. Just call today and say,
"Hey, Culligan man."
For a limited time, your local Culligan dealers are offering no money down, no interest, and no payments for 6 months.
Huck has been swamped with calls, begging him to repeat his humongous carpet remnant sale. Just because he loves you, Huck will extend the sale on every carpet remnant in the warehouse. Your choice, only $99 through this week only. 12 by 12, 12 by 15, 12 by 18, any size, just $99. While they last, Berber, Broadloop, or commercial, amazing at $99. This is your last chance. It's only through this week. Huck Finn's $99 remnant blowout. It's humongous.
Huck Finn's warehouse and more.
Spanking just seems to really breed violence.
It taught me love, it taught me respect, respect for my mother, respect for my elders.
I don't think you should spank ever.
You spare the rod, you spoil the kid.
Recently, we tackled an issue that everyone has an opinion about. Should you spank your child? I say, clearly, spanking is not okay and should only be used to protect your child from immediate danger. So I don't waffle on that, didn't then, don't now. And boy, did it ruffle some feathers. Now, Bob and his wife, Mimi, and their daughter say they completely disagree with me. Take a look.
No, told you, leave me. Okay, to your room, let's go, to your room.
Have you considered that if he is out of control and is being physical and being aggressive, that you engaging him physically and aggressively might, in fact, excite the situation or escalate the situation because it creates more chaos and noise for him in his life and his world?
I think that spanking brings about immediate results. The child knows very quickly that he's in trouble.
You said, "I got spanked when I deserved it, and I deserved it a lot." So that means you didn't learn from getting spanked the first 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 times. You would transgress again in some way. And my question is, what do you learn by being hit? You didn't learn squat. They do learn when they get hit is, I'm obviously a bad boy.
My wife and I think spanking is a very useful tool if it's used in the correct way. All it has to be is a couple of smart whacks to the buttocks, and the child knows all of a sudden, hey, listen to me, I'm trying to get your attention.
When we married and had children, we just expected our children to behave. If it took a spanking, then a spanking was what it took.
I didn't enjoy it, but that's the whole point of being spanked, and I intend to do that for my son now. I probably cannot get the same results when he's really testing me without spanking.
There are a lot of people that are messed up, and I think that if some of those children had been spanked when they were younger, that they would probably not be as bad as they are today.
So were you spanked when you were growing up?
Yes, I was.
And were you?
Yes.
Okay. And so you carried that on in spanking your children?
Occasionally.
And your daughter spanks her children?
Occasionally.
Okay, her child, occasionally. And one of my concerns, and I want to be real clear about this with you guys as an exemplar family on this issue, one of my concerns is that it can get out of control, it can get out of hand, and it can turn into an abusive situation. That's one of my big concerns with it, and I want to make it real clear to everybody watching at home, there's not even a hint of that situation in this family. So that's not,
thank you,
that's not an argument here. You guys have done this judiciously
and
sparingly,
also.
And so nothing inappropriate even suggested there. Now, having said that, I totally disagree with you spanking. All right.
And we totally disagree with you.
All right. So what is your argument? What do you think? What do you think spanking adds? What do you think it adds to the child's learning?
It gives them a clear and concise punishment that's going to happen. It doesn't always have to be used. It can be way down the line. And the child knows that that's in line. If they don't change their behavior, that could become part of the consequences.
It is a consequence that gets their attention, and then after the spanking, you talk to them and you reason with them. You say, this is dangerous. You cannot do this, or this might hurt somebody else. You cannot do this.
Okay, and does that cover that point about what it adds? It gets their attention.
It gets their
and you say it sets a clear boundary.
Absolutely.
I want y'all to make your points. I'm not trying to keep you from making your points.
Yeah.
Okay, but now, does it create confusion as well? Because let me tell you, if somebody comes, if I'm a child, and so I'm just kind of learning my way through the world, and somebody that I love and trust all of a sudden is inflicting physical pain on me, and then when they're through saying, I just did that because I love you, I'm just like, hey, go love somebody else, woman.
It really isn't about spanking. It's about being a parent. And children are a gift. And it is your responsibility as a parent to raise those children to be respectful of themselves, have self-respect, respect other people, to be kind, and
how
have values.
How does hitting the child help that?
A couple of little whacks gets them right into focus right now. Now we can talk about what you did that caused us to have to punish you.
I think the whole point of discipline is that we want the child to internalize the values and the message so they will apply it in our absence, correct?
We agree.
Yes, but is the value that they're going to internalize that they have to sit in the corner?
What?
What?
Well, what difference does it make? How is it incremental to that if you're hitting the kid?
No, don't
what
say hitting.
Don't
please.
Hit it. It's spank. Not hitting. Spanking's different than
hitting. You call it what you want. You are striking the child on the bottom or
it's
the leg
mild
or
punishment.
The hand.
Mild
okay.
punishment.
All right. It may be at your house, but let me tell you, you haven't been doing this for 30 years. You haven't worked with families, with mothers that go absolutely, if you've been to it for 30 years, then you know what I'm saying. So don't tell me you don't know that mothers and fathers do not get out of control in anger and abuse their children.
So this is our point. We don't need to be discussing what you do. We need to be discussing how we can help parents learn to be good parents.
But you know what? That's very idealistic. But the point is, millions of people are listening to me talk, and I know that the best way, you know, when I wanted my children to not get hit by a car, I said, you don't cross the street, period, without me there. I didn't leave any judgment in their mind to be made, because if they don't have a judgment to make, they can't make the wrong one. If parents don't spank, they are less likely to abuse the child while spanking.
The fact is that we're great parents, you're a great parent, But there are a lot of parents out there that are not great parents. And you said, I haven't seen it for 30 years. Yes, we have. I'm a school teacher. I see children that are abused all the time. I see children that are not disciplined, which is a form of abuse. And, you know, and they...
And let me say, I agree with that. I've said 1,000 times that overindulgence is one of the most insidious forms of child abuse known to man. I absolutely agree with that, no question about it. They have to have boundaries, they have to have discipline, they have to have control. I just don't think you have to hit them to do that.
You know, and I think it's your job as a...
I believe that every child has a lever. Mm-hmm. Every child has a lever.
Absolutely.
And maybe it's watching television, maybe it's getting to play with a toy, maybe it's a frown from mom or dad. There's a threshold and a level with every lever with every child.
No
disagreement. The reason I don't like spanking is because there are two risks involved that I don't think it's prudent to take. One is the risk of parents going too far and becoming abusive. And number two, there are risks of side effects. And you cannot ignore the psychosocial research and data on that. Not for your family, but for the society in general. And I'm going to put up on the website, because I know surveys show that the country is about 50-50 split on this. About 50% of the country believes spare the rod, spoil the child. About 50% say you don't need to do it. You can use the levers and the other things to do it.
Okay, point that I want to make is that what you said about being consistent is the most important thing. And if you use spanking, that's fine. And for the people that believe in it, I don't think somebody in your position should say it's wrong, because you have such an influence on so many people. And
do y'all have sound on your televisions?
Yes.
Do you have sound on your televisions? Because
yes.
I said in the show, this is my opinion, and I put pro and con research up there. I'm going to tell you my opinion, and I don't ever ask that anybody substitute my judgment for their own. But when I get through talking about it, you're not going to have to guess where I stand.
Or me either.
Okay? I don't think it's a good thing. I don't think it's a good thing. But
we could have a good show together.
I don't think it's a good thing, but I qualified that as my opinion. I gave pro spanking research. I gave non-pro spanking research on the website, so people could make up their own mind, and the country is evenly divided on.
Okay.
I am still dead set against it. Y'all think it's fine at your house. I think the risks are too high in the country in general. Okay, next, she's a single, sick of it, and says our project single girl really missed the mark. Find out what she thinks is the real reason there are so many 30-somethings still looking for love. We'll be right back.
Bill, I love you. I'm a big fan, and I think your intentions are good, but you just didn't get the whole picture. Why don't you talk to the men? Why don't you ask some questions like, why can't you be honest? Or say, how come you can't return a phone call? Not that hard.
Closed captioning provided by...
from Steven Spielberg.
It was the most loving experience of my life.
This is a woman's story. It's for the women and about them.
The Color Purple. Own it now on a 2-disc special edition DVD.
Once upon a time, when I was a little girl, I dreamed of marrying my prince, my knight in shining armor, having the most elegant reception. Sparkling champagne served in crystal, roses surrounding my wedding cake, sunlight shimmering through the clouds, and dancing the night away. Once upon a time, I had a dream of my beautiful wedding day, and today, my dream came true.
Attention Medicare recipients, you may be eligible for respiratory medication coverage. Call now for information.
If you use Preventol, Atrovent, Comavent, or other inhalers, Med4 Home can simplify your life.
If you meet coverage criteria, Medicare may cover a portion of premixed breathing medications and the nebulizer used to deliver them.
Call 1-800-335-6716 to speak to a pharmacy consultant. Med4 Home.